Morning. It's June 16th. So I've been over here over 4 months and one day now. Yeah. Was that a tick or was that a spider? We don't know. It wasn't on me, but it was in my tent. And he was a little stunned because I sprayed the base of my tent with permethrin, thank goodness. Anyway, headed to the waterfall. So this morning, headed to water. It's about a mile away. I'm out. I did have breakfast this morning and I drank my pills, but now I'm out of water. Boomer and Deadpool left without water, so we were able to give them some water and we're all good. Now we just have to get on up here. Planning on going 20 miles today. Status wise, my phone has a 3/4 charge on it. My batteries are dead. I got a little bit of charge at the welcome center yesterday, but so I'm on airplane mode. No phone calls for a couple days, which doesn't make my girlfriend happy, or my brother, or whatever, or me. That's the way it is. And try to maintain and take a few pictures and then put it all together in a couple of days, not today or tomorrow. So, but on that note, yay. Talk a second about resupply boxes. Applesauce sent me one to Native Landscapes and Gardening Center in Pauling. It's not really on gut hooks. It's right on the trail. It was a perfect resupply. He nailed me with it. It was 12 pounds, but, you know, and I bitch about any extra weight in my pack, but that was right on time. What it did, it allowed me so that I did not have to resupply in Kent. Kent is hiker friendly, but it's still very expensive, you know. Gotta fix my thing. I haven't done very many resupply boxes until just recently. Sweet Potato sent me one. Now, Applesauce sent me one. And Virginia sending me one in Massachusetts. I'll get that in a couple of days. Right now, I'm down to 3-day supply because I ate one of the supplies yesterday. I'm trying to stay, eat the whole box, keep my calories up. But yeah, it was right on time. It kept me from having to spend a lot of money at the IGA, which was very overpriced in Kent, in my opinion. I don't know how prices are up here in the north, but yeah, it was pretty expensive. Anyway, just thought I'd throw that note in there. Yeah, Ziploc. He left his charger at the laundromat in Kent. Well, he hopped off at the first road. It's a few miles around. He's got to go through Kent Furnace back to Kent and then come around and come on back. So he just left. So he's going to be out for hour or so, but he's a pretty quick hiker. I wished he had just hit his pack and then slack packed it back, but you know, he's young, he can do it. Thank you. That's great that girl came back and brought your battery. What the fuck? Hey.
I'm so happy.
What? Where did... you were calling her.
Yeah, I called the laundromat. Huh. I called her to see if she had it. She said, yeah, so I'll get her right down there. And then started walking down the road, and I'm like, I'm going to call her and act real sad.
Yeah, it wasn't too much of an act, right?
Yeah, it wasn't too much of an act.
It's road water.
You know any fast service on there anything? How far are you? Something like that.
Sweet.
I'll talk about it first, but Josh. You still have 5 minutes left in the jar.
Oh, yeah, I put it on for like, I only put it on for like 30 different minutes.
Oh, okay. Nice.
They say that there's a bypass trail that goes down and around to get across this brook. Yeah, I don't know. We'll see. When we get there. These rocks are pretty wicked. It goes from that tree, and then this tree tells you to come up. And we go up there, everybody kind of went that way. But actually, there's another one right here. So you actually go up between those two rocks. Pretty wicked. I'm standing under this because it's raining and I'm taking a break. So we get through here, we're gonna come down and go to a shelter, but I'm taking a break for a second. This beautiful, boulder-ridden, gorgeous place.